as I am not somebody who owns a Mac, but I do own an iPhone, so I wanted to dive into what the Craft mobile app looks like in 2022. Diving right into things, the setup on the homepage has all your basic things regarding your documents, start documents, your trash, and then your inbox. So to get started with the all documents, this is obviously something that you can scroll through the entirety of everything, but if I were to take one of these and go to the top right here, what I could do is I could actually take this page info, press start document, and then I would be able to see, if I go back to the start section, that I could quickly add things to the start pages. So now let's interact with one of these pages to see what you can do on the go. So once again, if we go to the top right, we can see we can actually edit page style and do some very nice export feature functionality in the mobile app. So a big thing that Craft prides itself on is the fact that it can export its pages extremely easily, and that data is your own. So you can share this with a secret link, and that link is essentially something where only the people who have access to this link and own this link can utilize it. And then if we see the settings part here, people can view all pages linked from this document. So you can actually do share blocks where they can only see it from specific blocks. And then you could also add comments, hide different comments on the page, and then choose different things like show title, show author, get rid of show created with Craft in the footer. And then as well, you can actually export this to not only a PDF, but an image. It can be easily printed from your phone. It could be sent to drafts, things, and a bunch of other different places. And then when we interact with one of these pages as well, in the top right here, if we go to the page in style, we can see that there's an option to add a cover image here or to get rid of the title, just as there is on your Mac or on the web app. And then also there's a cute little option here to show the author just in case it's used with multiple different people. And then going back into this page once again, we can see that there is opportunity to actually enable spell check. So if I press the English one here, I could actually enable spell check for this, and you'll see that all my little scribbles just ended up having an addition of spell check. So if you want to enable spell check, that's how you do it on the mobile app. And then in the top right, what we can do as well is have a little bit of a quick open functionality. If I were to type anything here, I could see an example. This is a folder. I could open an entire folder just by going to the top right and pressing this quick open functionality here. And then on the bottom, we actually have that same for search functionality. So something that I always like to test out with these applications is, can you search for things on specific pages rather than just titles? So if I go into one of these pages and I take this and I make it actual legible stuff, so I'm gonna just type legible text, and then I'm gonna exit out of this page. And then if I go into the search functionality, I can look up legible text, and you'll see that it actually finds the specific block that it is. So search anything within your documents, including all subpages. That ability is on the pro version. So that allowed me to find it. Now I could immediately access this if I have the pro version, but I don't. And then diving right into more parts of the functionality on this different page, let's see how the text functionality works and how you can interact with it. So from what I see here, you have the ability to add all these different things to blocks. So you have plain text, which is an option that you can type things out here. Press done. Now what else can I do here? Type things out like this. Now pressing those three dots, you can do things that are similar to what you could do on the app itself, and that would be convert it to a document. So if I press that, I could convert it to a document, and that took that and made it a new one. So if I go to my all documents here, took this typing this out like this and turned it into a page. Now in order to make different types of text, what I can do is I can press this uppercase A, lowercase A, and then you can see I can choose between heading, body, turning something into a page. If I press more, it would give me more options to make it a title. So an H1, subtitle H2, heading H3, and then I would have the different types of body to the text itself between strong, body, and caption. And then I could make a card in this mobile app pretty easily as well. And then I wanna go back to the other page to see what the functionality is regarding dragging this around. So if I can drag these around actually fairly simply. And then going back into this, you can see that uppercase A and lowercase A is where you can also do things like make to-do, checkboxes, toggle lists, normal lists, numbered lists, indent, and then change the color of the text as well. So this functionality all is really easy. And then even if you want to just add a divider, it's actually a quick access thing rather than it being like on the Notion app where you'd have to press plus and then add a divider. And then over here, this actually gives you the slash functionality too. So if we look at this again, this little slash with the page document there gives you the ability to do a bunch of different things like adding files and images and pretty much doing the majority of the markdown functionality right here. Because if I press the list one afterwards, it would then go into all of the different types of lists that exist, whether it be to do, toggle, bulleted list, and numbered list. And inserting a table is even possible here. If I press that and go to this 6x6, I can actually insert a table really easily on the mobile app, which I'm very impressed with how easy that was to do. Now, what I can appreciate about this app is the fact that it has this left option for markdown or this option for doing pretty much all the same kind of stuff right there. Really quickly, outside of that functionality is just the rest of the navigation to show you what it has for you. Now the inbox is something basically where it shows what you've done today. And then there's the entire functionality of folders in this where you can press into it and see what folders you have and then example subfolders that I've made. That all works just as well. And then whatever you'd have items remaining in the trash exists on top of that. And you have a nice look at the calendar that you have. And you can actually scroll through this functionality on this calendar area and make daily notes for yourself. So if I wanted to make a daily note page here, I would be able to basically see a log of all the different notes that I'd have throughout the different days. And this would be a nice place to jot down individual ideas that you had or a journal on a daily basis. And it would be able to keep a running log of that pretty easily. And you can have basic scroll functionality between the months as well as the days here. If you guys like this video, make sure to click on this one to see how you can improve your productivity even more.